Welcome. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to calculate a monthly car payment using Excel. I'm assuming that you have worked with Excel, you understand the difference between formulas and functions, and you know how to create a function. Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the worksheet I've created. As I mentioned, we're going to calculate a monthly car payment. I've entered three figures. One is the amount I'm borrowing from the bank or the credit union. The second number represents the interest rate I'll be paying to that institution for borrowing the money. And then the third figure represents in months how long I want to take before I pay back the amount that I've borrowed. Let's talk about the payment function. Just what is it? The payment function calculates the payment for a loan based on constant payments and a constant interest rate. So, how do I use the payment function and where can I find it? Like with any function in Excel, we go up to the ribbon bar, select the Formulas tab, and once you've selected that, you'll see the function library. Remember that the function library breaks down all the functions that are provided with the Excel program by category. The payment function can be found in the financial category. I just need to click on the drop-down arrow here, and you'll see that there are any number of different financial functions that can be used with Excel. They're listed alphabetically, so I'm going to scroll down until I find the payment function, which is represented as PMT. I'm going to go ahead and select that. And when I do that, because I have cell B6 selected, because that's where I want the monthly payment amount to be displayed, I see the function is already entered into that cell. And a window comes up that's called the Function Arguments window. And here is where Excel asks me for specific information. And in particular, it's asking me for the interest rate, the number of periods, and the present value. So let's start with the interest rate. The interest rate on this loan for my car is 4%. It's always best, rather than to enter the number, to enter the cell address. So I'm going to select this cell. And one thing that's a little bit tricky about the interest rate is that it's an annual interest rate. In other words, it's yearly. So because we're calculating a monthly payment, I need to divide that by 12. So I'm going to put a /12 following my cell address. Notice that with my cursor in this first box, if I wasn't sure what Excel meant by rate, I could look down here and I could see exactly what Excel was expecting from me. Next thing we're going to put in is the number of periods, N per, which is the total payments for the loan. And that can be found right here in cell B5. And the final piece of information Excel needs is the PV, or present value. In other words, how much money are you borrowing for that car? And of course, that's located right here in cell B3. Now, the interesting thing about the function arguments window is that once I put in my information, before I ever press OK and have the answer displayed in my cell here, I can look in the lower left-hand corner of this window, and Excel's going to give me a sneak peek at what the answer is. So I can see that the answer appears to be $331.50. And just by looking back at what I've entered, I can kind of determine whether or not that seems logical. In this case, it does. I'm going to go ahead and click OK. And my answer is now displayed in cell B6. Now, when you look at that answer, you might think to yourself, why is it in parentheses and why is it red? The reason it is because Excel recognizes this as a payment that you are making to another party, in this case to a bank or a credit union or some other institution. So it is money coming out of your pocket, therefore it's a debit or negative number. that sometimes is confusing to people. So there's a very easy way to fix that. We can come up here to the formula bar, slide our cursor in between the equal sign and the P in payment, and just insert a minus. When I press enter, you'll notice that now my monthly payment is represented more like what I was expecting. The real benefit of using the payment function to calculate your car payment is it gives you the ability to do what we call what-if scenarios. For example, if I look at the monthly payment and think to myself, you know, I probably could afford a little more expensive car. I could probably handle a payment maybe $400, $450 a month. So we can come up here and say, gee, what would happen if I purchased a car and financed $23,000? So I'm going to go ahead and change this number to 23,000, and automatically Excel recalculates my monthly payment and displays it for me. So now I can see if my interest rate hasn't changed and my number of payments hasn't changed, in other words, the length of my loan, I'm going to pay a little bit more, just under $100 more, if I purchase a more expensive car. What happens if I go back to my $18,000 and I get a deal on the interest rate? Maybe the credit union or bank is offering a special and the interest rate is 1.5% instead of 4%. So I can select that cell, change the number to 1.5, and I can see there's a huge change in my monthly payment. Another thing that I may want to do, I'm going to go back and change this back to 4%, is I may want to say, you know, I'm going to stick with the $18,000 that I'm going to borrow, but I'd like to pay this off sooner. I don't want to make payments for 5 years, so I think I'd like to make them for 4 instead. So I'm going to change that 60 to 48 for 4 years. Press the Enter key, and now I can see that my monthly payment goes up, but keep in mind the length of the loan is 1 year shorter. So to summarize, when using the payment function, there are three things Excel needs to know: how much you're borrowing, what the interest rate is, and how long you want to take to pay back the loan. Also remember that an interest rate is annual or yearly, so you must divide it by 12 when calculating your monthly payment. I hope you'll take some time and practice using the PMT function. It's a wonderful tool, whether it be for you personally or in business.